गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11, दिस इज द नेक्स्ट सेगमेंट ऑफ द वेक्टर चैप्टर और रदर से मोशन इन प्लेन दैट इज वन डायमेंशन एंड टू डायमेंशन मोशन चैप्टर. सो वी नो द थ्री डायमेंशन वेक्टर, हाउ विल गेट द रिजोल्यूशन वेक्टर फॉर थ्री डायमेंशन, टू डायमेंशन वी हैव डन. नाउ टूडे वी विल गो फॉर दैट पार्ट दैट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर, एडिशन ऑफ वेक्टर वी हैव डन. अच्छा सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर वी हैव डन. टुडे इज द पार्ट ऑफ डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर. सो मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेक्टर मीन्स इफ देयर आर टू वेक्टर्स, सपोज वन वेक्टर इज वेक्टर ए एंड अनदर वेक्टर इज वेक्टर ए एंड अनदर वेक्टर इज वेक्टर बी. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू डू मल्टीप्लीकेशन इन बिटवीन टू वेक्टर. नाउ सिंस इट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी मीन्स देयर आर सम डिफरेंट रूल्स टू गेट द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द वेक्टर्स. रिमेम्बर दैट ऑलवेज देयर इज टू टाइप ऑफ वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट, ऑलवेज देयर इज टू टाइप ऑफ रूल्स बाय विच वी कैन डू वेक्टर मल्टीप्लीकेशन. फर्स्ट रूल इज दैट इज वेक्टर स्केलर प्रोडक्ट. रिमेम्बर फर्स्ट रूल इज वेक्टर स्केलर प्रोडक्ट, अनदर रूल इज वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट, स्केलर प्रोडक्ट एंड वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट. रिमेम्बर दैट व्हेन वी परफॉर्म द मल्टीप्लीकेशन, इफ आफ्टर मल्टीप्लीकेशन आई एम गेटिंग अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी, if after multiplication of two vector quantity I am getting one scalar quantity, so that multiplication is called scalar product of vector multiplication. And when I am doing multiplication in between two vector quantity and as a result again I am getting another vector quantity, that is called vector product. Simply scalar product is called dot product, this one is called as dot product. Scalar product is called dot product and vector product is called cross product. So scalar product is called dot product and vector product is called cross product. Why? If I am telling you do multiplication in between vector A and B in terms of scalar multiplication, then what you will do, you will write it like that, A dot B, vector A dot B. Clear? This is scalar product sign or vector product. How we will do the multiplication? According to the formula of scalar product, we know that is A dot B is equal to magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B cos theta. From where I am getting theta? Suppose one vector is along this direction, this is vector A, another vector is moving along this direction, this is vector B. So this is the angle between these two, this is the angle between these two. Now if I want to multiply these two vector, so what I am doing, a dot b, if I do A dot B, then what I am getting according to the formula, that is equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta, magnitude of B A, magnitude of B cos theta. How? Let's go for that. See, if this is B, clear, this is B, then what is the component of B acting along A? What is the component of B acting along A? We know what? If this is my B vector, then component of B along A is B cos theta. Previous day we had done this. This is called B cos theta. Clear? So, if I do the multiplication, so magnitude of A I am taking, magnitude of B along direction of A, magnitude of B along direction of A will be the component of B will be what? B of cos theta. So if I do the multiplication, from where I want the scalar, So this is the formula you should remember, that is A dot B equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta. This is called scalar product. Now there are some properties of this scalar product you should know. First of all, the scalar product is always commutative. Means what? You are doing A dot B or B dot A, both will give the same value. Means if I am doing A dot B, that time suppose value is given 5, and if I am doing B dot A, that time also I will get 5. Clear? So the first property is that scalar product is commutative. Means you are performing A dot B or B dot A, both will give you the same result. Next one, scalar product is distributive. Means what? Distributive property means what? A, suppose A dot vector B plus vector C. So I can write A dot B plus A dot C. So vector product, vector scalar product is also distributive. Next property is that scalar product of two mutually perpendicular vector is zero. Means if the angle between two vector theta is 90 degree, then scalar product is zero. Means if someone is asking you ki scalar product of two vector is zero, then what is the angle between them? Then obviously the angle between them is 90 degree. How? Because we know A dot B equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta. Now if the angle between these two vector is 90 degree, which means here what I can write? Cos of 90 degree. What is the value of cos 90 degree? Zero. Therefore, if the angle between two vector is 90 degree or they are mutually perpendicular to each other, then what is happening? The scalar product in between the two vector will give me a zero. Next one, the scalar product of orthogonal vector. What are my orthogonal unit vector? We know I am having three orthogonal unit vector. Those are I cap, j cap, k cap. I cap, j cap, k cap. So means what? Suppose I am drawing over here again. So this one is what? For I cap, clear, x axis. This one is suppose what? K cap for z axis. And this one is what? J cap, I cap, j cap, k cap. So I dot j, I dot j. What is the angle between I and j? Angle between I and j is 90 degree. So I dot j will be 0. I dot j will be 0. J dot k will be 0. K dot I will be 0. Means two mutual, if I am doing scalar product in between two mutually perpendicular vectors, that will give me a 0. Clear? An orthogonal vector which have the angle between them is 90 degree. If I do the multiplication or scalar product in between them, that will give me a 0. And if I am doing the same multiplication in between I dot I, means one vector I along another parallel vector I am taking I. Achha, what is the angle between two parallel vector? Angle between two parallel vector is 0 degree. What is the value of cos 0? Cos 0 value is 1. Means I dot I always give me 1. Remember that. I dot I equal to j equal to k dot k. Means these all are cap. So all are give me 1. Clear? So coming for the next property. And that is, if suppose I have, how I will perform the vector scalar multiplication. Suppose I am having two vector. One vector A equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap plus AZ K cap. So I am having three vector, no confusion. Another vector I am having three component, that is another vector B equal to BX I cap plus BY J cap plus BJ K cap. I think no confusion. Clear? So if I do the scalar product in between them, that is A dot B. A dot B, this side will be what? Magnitude of A, magnitude of B cos theta. Clear? And this side A dot B will be equal to, I am doing over here, I am having a little bit of space. So A dot B will be equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap plus AZ K cap dot BX I cap plus BY J cap plus BZ K cap. Clear? BX I cap plus BY J cap plus BZ K cap. So, as we know, I dot J, I dot K will give me a zero. Means, which component will exist here? Only these two I will exist here. 2J will exist here, 2K will exist here. Because if I do the multiplication over I dot J, that will give me a 0. Means AX, BY will not exist. Similarly, AX, BZ will not exist. Why? Because I dot K again give me 0. Coming for the next, AY, BX means J dot I give me a 0. But AY, BY, J dot J is a 1. So, same unit vector quantity will exist, other will vanish. So, other will vanish. So, it will be AX, BY plus AY, sorry, this is AX, BX, sorry again. AY, BY plus AZ, BZ. So, this is the scalar product. When I will go for that further mathematical deduction, I will go further analysis and this will clear again. I will make it clear again. Actually, this is all about mechanics. So, we need to know first these rules. Then we will go for the application part. Okay? Thank you. Next, we are going for the vector product part. Now, see, we are discussing that vector product or cross product. So, if I am going for to do cross product, how will do? Suppose I am having one vector A, another vector B. So, one vector A, another vector B. So, how I will do the cross product? Sign of cross product means A cross B. No confusion. A cross B. What is the formula? A cross B is equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B, sine theta, n cap. Why n cap? Because after doing the product, whatever vector I am getting, it should have the direction. That direction is nothing but the direction of n k or the unit vector. Direction of n k or the unit vector. So, sin theta, why? Sin theta is the angle between, theta is the angle between A and B. Theta is the angle between A and B. So, if I am going to do that vector scalar product, let's go for the direction. Suppose one vector is moving along this direction. Another vector is moving along this direction. Okay, this is one vector, this is another vector. Suppose this vector is A and this vector is B. No confusion. Now, if A is crosses over B, remember, if A is crosses over B, the angle between A and B is how much? Theta. Angle between A and B is theta. So, if A is crosses over B, what is the direction? Remember that, so this thumb rule or screw rule. Screw rule means what? Suppose this is vector A, this is B. Clear? So A cross B means this is moving towards this. So the direction will be along the upward. Means this will be the direction of n cap. This will be the direction of n cap. A cross B. A is crosses over B. So this will be the direction. Similarly, if for the same thing, suppose this is B vector, this is A vector. B is crosses over A, means I am doing B cross A, so the direction will be downward direction, because again this is A, this is B. B crosses over A means this is B, this is A. So B cross A, this is the direction. A cross B, this is the direction. I am showing you. See, this is A vector, this is B. Can you see? So A cross B, this is the direction. B cross A, this will be the direction. What is the properties of that? And another thing, whenever I am doing A cross B or B cross A, whatever is that, I am getting that what? The plane vector or area vector. Area vector of what? Area vector in between this area. Means this is, if I join it, I will get this area. So I will get this area vector. Remember, whenever we are discussing in class 9, that is pressure. Pressure is what? Thrust per unit area. That time you are asking that pressure is a scalar quantity or vector quantity. I told you pressure is a scalar quantity. Why? Because that vector by vector quantity, that area there is actually what? A vector quantity. Why area is vector quantity? That is the discussion of class 12. So I am getting an area. Achha, remember that A cross B is the vector product. That will give me magnitude of A, magnitude of B of sine theta. Magnitude of A, magnitude of B of sine theta. What are the properties? First of all, the vector product is not commutative. Means what? A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Because as you see, that the directions will be different. So obviously A cross B will not equal to B cross A. Next one, the vector product is distributive. Same thing, means if I am doing A cross B plus C, so from there I will get A cross B plus A cross C. This is also distributive. Next one, the magnitude of the vector product of two vectors which are mutually perpendicular or orthogonal vector will give me that angle is equal to the product of the magnitude. Means if the angle sine theta is 90 degree, what is the value of sine 90? Sine 90 is 1. Means that time A cross B is just equal to the magnitude multiplication of their magnitude. Next one, the product of two parallel vector. Product of two parallel vector means angle between them is 0 degree. Sine 0 degree is what? We know 0. Means parallel vector is there, their cross product is give us a 0. Okay. Now the product of two, product of that orthogonal unit vector. This is very important. Even for that, there is a very important rule. That is, whenever I am doing I cross J. So I is suppose along this direction, J cross J is along this direction. What is the angle between I cross J? I cross J is 90 degree, okay? So I cross J, if I do this one, suppose this is I, this is J. So I cross J, give me the direction of K. I cross J will give me K. J cross I, J cap cross I cap, give me what? J cross I. I cross J equal to K, but J cross I will be minus K cap, means along this direction, minus K cap. J cross I equal to minus K cap. Done. Now coming for the next one, that is I cross K. So I cross K will give me I cross K. Let's see. So here I am having I, here I am having K. So I cross K, give me what? Another mutual perpendicular, that is J. I cross K is giving me J, but K cross I give me minus j. Clear? So to remember this, I am having a very interesting thing, that is, think about a circle. Clear? Right here I, j, and here I am having k. Always proceed as clockwise direction. Remember that if there is a breaking of cyclic order, so I will have a negative sign. Means I cross j. First is I, next is j. So I cross j will give me k. J cross k give me what? J cross k will give me I. On the vice versa, k cross j means the anticlockwise, so it will give me I. Now k cross I, again a cyclic version, clockwise version, k cross I will give me j. Clear? K cross I will give me j. Sorry, here I have written wrong. That is k cross I equal to j and I cross k equal to minus j. Okay, so k cross I will give me what? J. But I cross k will be a breaking of the cyclic order, so minus j. So from there, what I can write? I cross j means k cap. Clear? J cross k means what? I. No confusion. Next one. K cross I. K cap cross I cap will give me what? J. And reverse of everything will give me a minus sign. Clear? Now, how I will do A cross B. This is the orthogonal vector. Now, the most important part, that is, if suppose vector A equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap, AZ K cap. Clear? And vector B equal to BX I cap plus BY J cap plus BZ K cap. Clear? So how I will do A cross B? There is a formula. You should remember A cross B. See, A cross B equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B, sine theta, no problem. But if simply I need to calculate A cross B, how I will do? I need that time the formula of determinant. Determinant. Clear? That you will know, do in class 12 or 11 in algebra part, determinant, matrix determinant chapter. Now I am just telling you in a concise manner so you can memorize and do the sum of respective chapter. This is the determinant sign, a long bracket, this kind of bar sign, straight line. This is determinant sign. So first I will write all the three orthogonal unit vector. So I cap, J cap, K cap. What is the rules? First, who is there? A is there, second B. So first I will write all the component of I, J, K which belongs to A. So AX, only component, that this part, magnitude part. AX, AY, AZ. Now for B, what I am having? BX, BY, BZ. Write down. So BX, BY, BZ. Done. Now, how I will solve the determinant? The rule of the determinant is row, column. Clear? So whenever I will do that first column, first row. So what I will do? First I cap is there, so I will take I cap common. So I cap common I am taking. So I will forget about this and this. Completely forget about this. So who is remaining? I am having only these four components. The rule is this into this minus this into this. Remember, AY into BZ minus AZ into BY. So rule is that. So AY BZ minus by is it clear? Now when I will go for the j cap, remember the first column should have a plus sign, next column minus sign, next column another plus sign. Why this? This answer you will get in class 12. Right now just remember, first column plus sign, second column minus sign, next column plus sign. So j cap should have a minus sign. This you will remember. Please don't write in exam here minus. Just remember that in your back of the mind, that is j should have a minus sign. So minus j cap. So again I will forget about whom? This column and this one. So who is remaining right now? Ax, bx remaining and az, bz remaining. So I will multiply ax into bz, this into this. So ax, bz minus this into this, bx, az, done. Now coming for this one, plus k cap. So plus k cap. So I will forget about this and this. So who is remaining? These fours are remaining. These fours are remaining. So I will do ax by minus bx ay. Done. So by that I will do that cross multiplication, or I can say that is cross product. So this is all about cross product. Now I will go for that few numericals or few practice chapter, because otherwise few numericals which based on vector, otherwise you will not get the full concept. So one after one I will do and I will make the concept again clear. Okay, let's go for the numericals. So coming for the first numerical, that is given if vector A equal to minus 2i cap plus 2j cap minus kk cap and vector B equal to 3i cap plus 6j cap plus 2k cap, determine the angle between them. Means two vector given, vector A equal to minus 2i cap minus 2i cap plus 2j cap plus 2j cap, clear? And minus k cap, no confusion. And vector B equal to what is given there, vector B equal to 3i cap plus 6j cap plus 6j cap plus 2k cap. I need to find out the angle between them. So how I will find out the angle between them? Means simply I need the value of theta. Either I will do cross product or dot product. Since cross means I need theta, sine theta or cos theta, whatever may be, I need theta. Since theta means whenever I am doing that cross product, cross product is little bit complex, then if there is no vector requirement of vector, so always I will do what? Scalar product. So A dot B, let's do. Therefore we know vector A dot vector B equal to magnitude of A magnitude of B of cos theta. I will calculate this theta. Before that, let's first calculate magnitude of A. So magnitude of A means what? What I know? Magnitude of A means root under this square plus this square plus this square. So minus 2 whole square plus 2 square plus minus 1 whole square, which give me 2 to the 4, 8, 9. So root 9, that is equal to 3. No confusion. 3. And next one, magnitude of B is root under 3 square plus 6 square plus 2 square, that is equal to root under 3 3 is 9 plus 36 plus 4. 9 plus 36 plus 4 means that will give me 49. So 49. So that is equal to 7. No confusion. Now let's do. Therefore, put A in place of A. Put that whole things. -2i cap + 2j cap - k cap dot these whole things. That is 3i cap + 6j cap + 2k cap. Put done. Now this magnitude part means 3 into 7 cos theta. Now I know what only I component, J component, K component will exist, because I dot J, J dot K will vanish automatically. So this will be multiplied with this. So -2 into 3, that is -6. 2 into 6, that is +12. -1 2 -2, that is equal to 2 7 3 7 3 is 21 cos theta. So that is equal to, from here what I will get, -6, that is 4, it is 10 10 10 minus 3 10 10 minus 6 is 4. Okay, 4 21 of cos theta. So cos theta will be, I am doing here, so cos theta equal to 4 by 21. Whenever you will study trigonometry formula, you will get a thing that is inverse. Means cos theta equal to 4 by 21. So what is the value of theta? Theta will be cos inverse. Cos inverse 4 by 21. This inverse is just the discussion part of class. Mathematics class, just here I am just letting you know that that is cos inverse means cos theta is something. So theta equal to cos will coming this side. So cos inverse 4 by 21. This is the angle between the two vector. Clear? I am coming for the next numerical. Next numerical is find the vector which is parallel to the resultant of the vector A and B, where A equal to 2i cap - 6j cap - 3k cap, and vector B equal to 4i cap + 3j cap - k cap. Means I need to find out one vector which is just parallel to the resultant of these two vectors. So first I will calculate resultant vector. Resultant vector, let's go for that. So what are the things given? A, vector A given. Vector A equal to given that 2i cap - 6j cap. 2i cap - 6j cap. And -3k cap. And vector B equal to how much given? That is 4i cap + 3j cap - k cap. So I am having these two vectors. First, let's find out the resultant of these two vectors. Then I will go for the parallel vector. There I will coming for that next. Acha. How I will find out the resultant vector? See, I know the vector resultant is equal to, means I will find out the addition of two vector if the subtraction is not mentioned. Now see one thing, angle is not given over there. So what is the angle between these two vector? That knowledge I don't have. So if they are asking me the resultant for 2 marks or 3 marks, simply go for the simple resultant, means A plus B. Okay. So resultant vector R equal to vector A plus vector B, since angle not given. So resultant vector A R equal to A plus B, done. Now that is equal to माइनस सिक्स जे कैप माइनस थ्री के कैप प्लस फोर आई कैप प्लस थ्री जे कैप माइनस के कैप डन. सो लेट्स गो फॉर दैट. सो फ्रॉम देयर व्हाट आई विल गेट दिस प्लस दिस दैट इज टू प्लस फोर. हाउ मच टू प्लस फोर इज सिक्स आई कैप माइनस सिक्स प्लस थ्री माइनस थ्री जे कैप माइनस थ्री माइनस के माइनस फोर के कैप. सो आई एम हैविंग द रिजल्ट इन वेक्टर दैट इज सिक्स आई कैप दैट इज सिक्स आई कैप माइनस थ्री जे कैप माइनस फोर के कैप. सो लेट्स गो फॉर द मैग्नीट्यूड बिकॉज आई नीड द पैरेलल वेक्टर व्हिच इज पैरेलल टू दिस resultant vector r means which one is parallel to this vector. So let's go for that. So vector r equal to magnitude of that is root under 6 square plus minus 3 whole square plus minus 4 whole square. Now I am telling you what. Suppose this is one vector, this is another vector. Resultant of these two vector is moving along. Suppose this one. So actually if I want a parallel vector, so if this is the direction of resultant, parallel vector direction also along this direction. Parallel vector direction also along this direction. Clear? So if this is my value of the vector, so what should be the this is the value of the vector, what should be the direction? Direction vector or the unit vector will also parallel to this vector. Clear? So if I got that unit vector, so I will get what? The parallel vector. So magnitude is what here? That is 36 plus 9 plus 16. 36 plus 9 plus 16. So that is equal to what? 61. So that is equal to root under 61. So the vector which is parallel to the resultant vector means that r cap, direction of the vector r cap will be magnitude of the vector divided by the magnitude, because the vector, this one, this is the vector. What is the direction? Direction means with that I need a unit vector. Remember that scalar vector product, there is a n cap which is the direction of that cross product. Similarly, whenever I need to say you regarding a vector quantity, I should specify the direction, because if a vector quantity is splitted in three dimensional coordinate system, so it is very difficult to make us understood that is what is the direction. So I am going for what? That r cap, r cap will be equal to r by that magnitude, that r vector by that magnitude of that. So that is equal to 6 I cap minus 3 j cap minus 4 k cap whole divided by root 61. So this is the vector which is parallel to the resultant of vector A and B. This is the vector which is parallel to the resultant of vector A and B. See, first time you are doing this chapter, very new to you. There is so new concept is coming day by day. You need to habituate with these things. So it will take time, but trust me, it is not very tough. Okay, now I am going for the next numerical.